Today's National Trust travel blog, I have come to Montacute House in Somerset. It's very near to Yeovil, it's probably 4 miles away from Yeovil. It's an Elizabethan house and gardens, and which means that I can get away with playing all my period music, because I purchased from AKM Music, I purchased some royalty-free music and never had the chance to play it, but now I can, so that's really good. Get away with that. So we're going to go off into the house in a second. However, I just wanted to talk about unloading my scooter. I've had to move my car from a disabled spot because the bay seems to be on a slope and my scooter wouldn't go down to the floor. It was about 3 inches or so off the floor, so obviously I couldn't unhook it. I'll show you the actual bay itself, but I had to move it to another bay because I couldn't unload my scooter. So that's really silly. But we'll have a look at that in a second. It's difficult to see, but you can see that there's a little bit of a slope there, and just enough to stop me from unloading my scooter. Now you can see that there's a money shop, not quite a money shop, but over the house, just to the top of the house there, and we're going to go in through the gate there.
£12.60.
Right, shall we go and find a couple of little Speed Alone. Cheers. Do you want a map?
No,
you're
seeing them.
They're
going to
do it anyway. So you're saying if you want to
stretch around
there, you'll see them.
Hello.
Hello. Thank you very much. You come to take some pictures of birds.
Yes.
There we go.
Lots
Thank
of
you.
Things in there.
Do you know where the Falcon
Readers
Play is?
No idea. Never been
Have you
here.
Been here before?
Never been.
Are you happy for me to draw on this?
Yeah.
So we are here at number 8.
Right.
You have the toilets on the left, the cafe and the shop on the right. If you do want to go into the shop, however, it might be worth coming back through reception and going through the door in reception, just because there's a step on this side.
Okay.
But it's flat on the car park entrance. The falconry display is here, and they're just about to start now.
Oh, okay.
So if you head straight round there, just go through the hedge down the side of the house and through the hedge there, you'll see them. The whole of the grounds are pretty accessible. It's just stairs in this area that take you down, but you can get all the way around it anyway.
Yeah.
There is a ramp entrance to the back of the house, just here, that will take you into the
ground floor. Yep.
All right. Have a
lovely
day.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Cheers. Thank you. Get somebody stood in front of me. So this is a falconry display. We're going to fly some birds and we'll see what that's like. Don't know where they're going to do it from or where they're going to go to. We'll see.
And if this weather's anything to go by and how the birds flew last weekend, we're hoping for a good show this weekend, so stay tuned. So myself and my wife here, Albion Historical Falconry. Now, we specialise in studying the historical falconry techniques that were used throughout most of the historical periods in the UK. Now, originally I was trained using the modern techniques. I was taught that a bird doesn't bond with you, a bird doesn't love you, a bird doesn't want to be with you. You just control the bird through its hunger. So you take the food away from the bird, and eventually the bird becomes hungry and do what you like. Although I did find there was a few problems with this. If your bird caught something out in the field and ate it before you got there, the bird got lost because it only came back to you because it was hungry. So what was falconry used for? Has anyone got an idea what falconry might have been used for? It's a bit of a trick question here. Anyone got an idea what would we use for? No one? Okay. Well, falconry predominantly, rather than actually hunting, was used for political purposes. Now, the falcons, what they catch isn't really enough to feed you. You can't really live off what a falcon can catch, so really they were used for sport. Now you've got to remember in history these birds could have been imported from right the way across the world, so the wealth of one of these birds would be the equivalent of what we pay for, say, a Ferrari sports car today. So a lot of money. Now there was a different type of person who flew birds of prey, and he was called an ostringer. Now this is where our modern term ostracised comes from, because the ostringer would be out with our native hawks. We have the Accipiter gentilis, the goshawk, and Accipiter nisus, the sparrowhawk. And these are prolific killers, and you can literally live off what one bird can catch. So an ostringer would be out all day on his own with his bird in the woods, bringing in food for the kitchen tables. And this is where the term ostracised comes from, because he was ostracised from a society.
There's a ramp. Down. They've got the ramp in there. There's gravel in there. Don't know whether I want to go in on the gravel. There is the house. Very nice. ramp into the house. Yes, there is. Wow, that is steep. That is flipping steep. My God, I don't think I'm going to get up that. What I'll do is I'll reverse.
Yeah, just straight up. Oh, steady. Are you okay?
Yeah, I should have gone it backwards. I have to come up the other one backwards because it's too steep.
Just be careful and I'll.
Yeah, that was fun.
Your bar is catching on the thing. I think you see most people go up that way without you.
It was tipping up.
Yeah, I know. It's too. I don't want you to fall out. So yeah. I'll just help these other people, and I'll come and see what I can. Okay, I'll just tell you which way. I'll just give you some information in a moment.
Yeah.
All right. Welcome to Montague. Have you been before? You start off in the hall. There's two rooms at the far end. Then you go up the stairs in the corner. There's two more floors, and then you come back by the dining room. There's a tray of the two little ones want to do it. It's on the table. There's a table on the left with some clipboards and little cards, okay?
Right.
So you can do that if you want to. If you've got a camera, you can use it with the flash off.
All right. Yeah.
Okay, and there's information all the way around if people talk to you if you need it.
Yeah.
There's cards and books in various places.
Yeah.
Okay. Enjoy your visit.
All right, thank you.
Right, did you hear most of that?
Yes.
I'm afraid you're not going to be able to
get
upstairs.
No.
If you can, just be careful. You can get into the two rooms at the end.
Okay, I'm a good
And
driver.
In the kitchen, we've got an iPad you can use with the other two floors.
Okay.
All right, when you're ready.
Yeah.
All right?
That sounds good.
Okay. I'll get when my help comes back, I'll get them to show you where the iPad is.
Yeah, all right.
Thank you.
upstairs. Was easier than I thought.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm going to have to go a little bit fast. Yeah, I'm going to have to go a little bit fast.
That's fine, yeah.
Because of that thing down there, which is probably going to get stuck. That's it. It's alright, it's on carpet. It's on them. So this is the kitchen.
Sorry?
Wow. Kitchen.
This is the kitchen. As long as we just leave a bit of a gap so that people can... Yeah. That's all right. That'll be okay.
Go here.
Yeah. Which side? That side?
Yeah.
Okay. It's slightly temperamental. Are you okay with iPads,
yeah,
I'm sure?
Yeah.
It's just a bit temperamental. You have to be slow with it. It doesn't like it if you keep sort of, it gets a bit, it freezes.
Like me then.
Yeah, a bit like me. So basically all you do, there's some other books about the kitchen as well. There's a recipe book and that's about, that's the other information, okay?
Yeah.
So there you are.
Wow.
All right.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. The kitchen is sort of original. The range is Victorian.
Oh, okay.
They would have had a spit.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow. Right then, so I'll see you in a few minutes. I'm just going to have a little look at the iPad and the recipe book, and I'll be back to you in a moment.
You okay?
Yes.
Are you going this way?
Yes,
okay,
that's
fine. Have you been here before?
Thank you, yes.
Thank you very much.
It was
really good.
Yes.
Thank you. Cheers.
Are you okay?
Yeah. I don't know why it does that. Doing that lot now. Garden. Who needs to see it? I can see it from here. Right, I'm going to head back out to the front and see if I can find the toilet now. Thing. Really. Just to remind you, this is the rear entrance. And this scooter is going to get a real kick in a minute, because it keeps on skidding to a stop. That's basically really annoying.
Yeah, that might be enough to go around there.
quite big, actually. The So you have to hold the door open while you go out. Because it shuts.
Thank you. Lovely. He said, lovely. Thank you. Managed to hit the house as well. Oh, good. Yeah, you are smashing. Thank you. A bit steep. The bit steep. It is a bit steep. Yeah. Sorry about that. Yeah. Thank you. A bit worried about the one inside the ledge.
Before you get up onto the ramp.
Yeah. Okay, I'll feed that back.
I got stuck on it.
Oh, did they help you?
Yeah, it's no problem. I got up in the end, but it was just that.
It's good to know things like that. Yeah. I'll feed that back.
Yeah, no problem.
So, we were aware the one
at
the back was a bit steep. I think we have a few issues.
I went out backwards. Yeah, no problem.
Okay,
thank you. Right, cheers. Right then, so that's the end of my National Trust visit to Montacute House. Really enjoyed it in some places, and other places I did not enjoy it, especially when I nearly came off backwards going up the ramp, second ramp, not the first ramp. The first ramp I went up backwards and it was fine, but the second ramp obviously was a bit, yeah. So if you have enjoyed it, then please don't forget to like and share and subscribe, and I will catch you again for the next travel vlog. Thank you for watching.